Hello, I'm Lieutenant General Todd Semonite, 54th Chief of Engineers, and today I'm down at Erdick in Vicksburg, Mississippi, with the Coastal Hydraulics Lab. You know, this week is actually Engineer Week, and the theme for this week is Invent Amazing. Now, you want to talk about amazing things, let me tell you what the guys just showed me here down at Erdick. This is actually a mini robotic submersible dredge that we can use for several different functions. With me is Thad Pratt. He's got a bunch of guys on his team, and they've done a phenomenal job of creating this capability that we can either use for military operations, civil works, or even disaster recovery. Thad, what in the world is this? And tell our team a little bit about some of the great things you guys created.
Okay, well, what we have here is a submersible mini robotic dredge. This portion right here can actually go underwater with a 300-foot umbilical cord. It detaches from its hydraulic power unit to supply it power. It can work approximately 300 feet from the actual control unit. It has full control horizontally and vertically of the cutter head. It has three different types of heads that go on the front. Cutter head, a more refined cutter head for working around close objects like concrete if you wanted to do something on a civil works project, or a water injection head if you wanted to do something kind of gradually retrieve something that was buried and you didn't want to destroy it. We have complete control of positioning. We know where we are in the world when we're dredging, so we can dredge a template, we can cut a canal, a channel, we can dredge around a wharf, a pier, to provide access for both military or humanitarian aid exercises. This complete system packs up into four Connex boxes. It's flyable. A four-man team can run it. It's very easy to deploy. It can either drive off the shoreline, you could crane it down to the bottom and let it work, or you could detach this whole mechanism from the carriage and attach it to a track hoe.
So let me just back brief a little bit here. So basically, this front section is separate from the other one, but it's connected by this umbilical cord. You've got a controller, so on a beach, if you had an obstacle and you had to go ahead and dredge in part of the beach, so then a boat could come right in and offload, you could actually have a guy right there. You can also, it's all wireless, so you can also do it back from the control booth if you needed to be. When this goes around, all of the umbilicals mainly work in the electronics part, but that actually there's a hole down in the bottom with about an 8-inch pipe that sucks it right out and then is able to get the dredge material back out. The other thing you told me that I'm really excited about, this is great because it actually can work underground. We pulled the Intrepid out several years ago, and there was mud all the way around the bottom of the Intrepid. But here, you could actually crane it down in, take it under a ship, go around. You've got sensors on the front, cameras and
sonar,
so you could actually get very, very close to the bottom of a ship and be able to get it back in. However, though, you could also unplug this and actually hook it on the front of an excavator, a Caterpillar excavator of some sort, put that on a dredge, and then you could take that in any one of our core lakes and dams, and to be able to, this is all the front end, you still get the umbilical, but you could go right on down. If there was, let's say, a lot of sediment down around the bottom of a control structure or an inlet we needed to get out, you could pull that whole thing back down. This really is amazing. So tell me, where are we at as far as the prototyping and the testing?
Well, this is the prototype, and we're in the process of testing the pumps and the production rates and control mechanisms and the sensing capability of the sonar and the different cameras and lighting systems that we have. So this year, we're going to be testing it out and demoing it.
So this is just an example of, you know, the real power of what Erdick brings to the fight. Here again, to be able to take care of, let's say, Marines coming into a beach, what's called logistics over the shore, all the capabilities we need to do for military operations, civil works, or disaster response. Even back here, Thad, this is one of your survey vessels that is a remote, and you can actually go down underneath here. They've actually gone down underneath the pier and look at the substructure of where it could be damaged. If you had a pier like this with a bunch of damage, you could take that vessel, go around it, find out what's broken, and even on here, they've got a couple examples of how they go under the pier and actually put splines on or some type of a brace filled with concrete and an overbridge system to be able to make it happen. So I'm really impressed with what you guys are doing here, and I think that's what Erdick does every day. cutting-edge technology to be able to figure out what's the problem the warfighters have or we have in civil works, and then how do you guys use an ingenuity and innovation, you really do develop amazing results. So, Thad, on behalf of Dr. Pittman and all the rest of the crew, congratulations on a job well done. I want to see this out working someday.
Once the test,
I'm coming out. You let me know. I'm flying out. And we'll see you working. But thanks for the great job you guys do at ERDC. Hey, so from Vicksburg, Mississippi, you talk about invent amazing. Here it is, a submersible dredge.